not quite sure if Alex, who is driving the Magical Mystery Tour bus, is listening over in Ipswich this morning, but there's a tune we should be doing with the Blue Shades. Happy Together from the Turtles. So on Monday morning, 101 FM, I absolutely love it. You know, what normally happens, if people are due to come on a show and then for whatever reasons they can't come on, I'll put a little message out on Facebook. And it says on Facebook, hey, who wants to come on the radio show on Monday morning? We had a lot of responses, but there was one that really sort of got my interest straight away, and it came from a lady called Tanya Clancy, and she said, hey, you should interview my son Samuel, because he's 9 years old, and he's a pretty good kid, and he does photographs, and he does stuff for charity. Oh, by the way, he actually won the Logan Young Citizen of the Year Award, and I'm thinking, well, it would be rude not to. So first of all, good morning to Samuel.
Good morning.
And good morning, Mum.
Good morning.
Great to have you guys here. And Samuel, I have to say, we've just been chatting about cameras, and you've got a pretty good camera, haven't you?
Yeah.
What kind is it?
Canon.
See, Canon. You know what? I reckon that Mum and Dad have really looked after this lad. And so tell me what, first of all, you know, most young people of 9 years of age spend all of the time on Facebook and Instagram and Snapchat and all the rest of it and on their iPads. And you have got a different attitude. You do stuff for other people. Why do you do that?
I found out my granddad had cancer, and I found out that other people could get sick like that too, so I wanted to help other people that are very sick.
Which is such a good thing. It's a lovely thing to do. And tell me a little bit about the calendar that you made.
Well, I go around to different areas in Brisbane and take some photos, and I'll put it into a calendar and sell it, and all the money goes to the Starlight Foundation.
Which is absolutely fantastic. I mean, Mum, you are beaming here, right? As any mum would, as any parent would. You must be so proud. And you're a testament to you and to Samuel's dad for the upbringing.
Oh, thank you, Mike. Yeah, we're very proud that he's doing something that helps other people. And just meeting some of the people that he's helped, and he's been taking photos of some families that have been in hospital and giving them as gifts, and just meeting them and hearing how much that means to them, it warms our hearts.
Which it must do, because, you know, we've got a lot of people, we talk about young people a lot on the show, and, you know, to have somebody of 9 years old that's got that sort of dedication and actually realise, you know what, there's some people worse off than us and doing something about it. Let me ask you a little bit about what you did at Christmas. It was called 15 Days of Kindness. What was that all about?
My mum told me that some people get hard times at Christmas because they don't have a lot of money. So we did the 15 Days of Kindness to help other people.
You know, when you say the 15 Days of Kindness, what did you actually do as part of that? Because somebody told me you actually emptied your own piggy bank for this.
Yes, I emptied my piggy bank to buy a trolley voucher from the lighthouse, and then I gave it to a mother and two children.
Can I just tell you that every single listener to 101 FM right now wants to adopt your son? I got to tell you that, Tanya, you know, because the thing is, we only hear the bad stuff. And that's why I was so, when you sent me the information, I thought, wow, isn't it nice to have a positive story about a young man who actually cares? So we were talking about Facebook as well. And apparently you did a little Facebook video. What was that all about?
Well, it's normally about things when I need, like, some donations or help for little things.
Because Facebook's really good, isn't it? And, you know, you get lots and lots of you know, people sort of responding to you. And what did they say about your video? What were people saying about it?
Samuel had so many people from the public. We weren't expecting the response that he got, but he did just recently, he did a gift pack for homeless people. So lots of donations came in for that. He also did at just after Christmas, he collected a lot of school supplies.
Yeah.
For children, he had some leftover supplies himself, and he thought, why not give his supplies to other children? And so he did a video, and it just went viral, and we ended up with a lot of supplies.
Because I heard you had over 4,000 donations, is that right?
Yeah.
Wow. I mean, you need to store this stuff somewhere. I would imagine all of a sudden, can't park the car in there because we've got all these donations and whatever. What was it like when you, first of all, you found out you were going to be the Young Citizen of the Year here in Logan? I mean, how good was that?
Well, I didn't know I was going to be the Young Citizen of the Year. I just found out that I was going to be nominated, and I didn't know the rest.
But, you know, it's just absolutely amazing. And this is not, you know, I was saying to Samuel, oh, you know, it's fine, don't worry about this, it's radio, there's only the current Mrs. Bennett listening and nobody else. And he said, that's all right, I have been on Channel 7, I've been in a TV studio. I'm thinking, oh, okay. So you're kind of getting used to all of this media appearance stuff as well, you know, and all this fame and fortune, don't let it go to his head, Mum, whatever you do.
Oh, no. We keep him very grounded and, yeah, no.
And you got some big ideas coming up, Samuel, haven't you? Another calendar for this year?
Yes. I'm going to make a calendar for 2018.
Okay, that's terrific.
Last year I made a calendar for 2017, which is this year.
Yeah, which is really brilliant. And I know that, again, all the stuff that your mum's been telling me about helping the animals in the animal shelter, I mean, that's obviously important to you as well.
Yes. They are like humans, but instead they're animals, and I don't want them to be put down, so I'm gonna take photos of them and send them out so people could come and get them.
Yes. Find new homes, yes.
Absolutely fantastic. And you know what? Animals are like humans, just a lot nicer, yeah. Which is what I say. You know what, Tanya? I mean, I'm so glad that you responded to our little message on Facebook. And, you know, this young man is, I reckon, when you think about it, actually, Sam, you remember me when you are the Prime Minister, okay? and that's going to be difficult because you're too nice to be a politician, so we need to work on that. But when you're Prime Minister, just remember when you did your first radio interview. As I said before, you must be so proud, and the family as well, to have this young man doing all of this great work for charity, and he does it because he wants to.
Actually, it's taught us a lot of things. I mean, Samuel and I were driving around visiting different Logan residents that were offering to donate, and the people in the community are just so warm and giving, and that's the stuff that Samuel and I talk about when we drive away, just the generosity of and kindness of others that are out there as well. So, you know, he's teaching us a lot as well. Yeah.
Which is fantastic. Well, we are so pleased that you came into the studio this morning. I'm sorry that we can't keep you here all morning, so you're going to have to go back to school, which is a bit of a drag. But hey, when it's break time and you're saying, and your mates are saying, so what did you do over the weekend? Well, actually, I was on live radio this morning. What did you do? Is the way you can respond to that. So if people want to get a hold of Samuel, if they want to find out and make donations and just find out about the work he does, where do they go?
So you can follow Samuel on Samuel G Photography and Fundraiser Facebook page. He's got some exciting things coming up where he's going to be doing another fundraiser shortly for the homeless, again with blankets and things like that. The other thing he's doing is a video. A friend is going to be singing a video, and Samuel's going to be doing the film clip of it. So all the money's going to go, it's about a sick child, and all the money's going to go to his fundraising page. So yeah, it's going to be all to help the sick children. So it'll be fantastic. If you want to help and get on board, we'd love for you to help out.
Well, I'm sure that our listeners, after listening to you and Samuel this morning, will definitely be getting on board. If you missed the details, you can give Lorraine a call here at 101 FM 3808 1101, and we will put you, Samuel and Tanya, in touch with each other. Samuel, thank you so much for coming into the studio. Will you come back and tell us about more of the work that you've done?
Yes.
We'd love to.
Yeah. Thank you.
Oh, no, you are more than welcome. What a polite young man as well. And I tell you what, at a time when we're always turning around and saying that kids are this and kids are that, what an absolute joy to have Samuel and Tanya in the studio. If you want any more, give us a ring, 3808-1101. And yes, whew, I tell you what, for our other guests coming on today, how do you follow that?
The Monday Morning Show with Mike Bennett on Logan City's 101 FM.